is the overview of the Ventus ambidextrous laser gaming mouse software. For the Ventus mouse, you can have 5 profiles on the mouse at any time. Say you're playing a game and you might need only one or two at a time. You can also further disable the other profiles via this button right here. The blue one is for the on-off switch. And then if you want to create more than 5 profiles, you can also store them on your computer by creating a new profile, setting up the settings you want, and you can export them and save them. Oh, here's a normal and battle mode switch. In normal mode, the LED lights on the mouse will behave as normal, which will be pulse lighting. In battle mode, it will adjust to the clicking frequency of your mouse. Under that, you can see a picture of a mouse. If you hover over the buttons, it will point out to what the functions are currently mapped to, or you can just directly come here, and it will also still point to the button. And then here you can set up for the buttons, if you have their normal function, a macro key, which with macros you need a program in the macro manager, a single key, which is just like remapping it to a key on the keyboard. You can also make it change the DPI. You can just disable the key altogether, or you can even make it launch a specific program if you want. For the thumb button, it's a little bit more different. Regarding DPI, you can also set it to temporary, which is like a what people call sniper button, which means that when you hold on to the button, it will switch to a certain DPI, and this is only for when you hold on to it, and as soon as you let it go, it will switch back to normal. Over here on the right is the performance options, where you can set the different DPI levels of the mouse. You can choose between 1 to 4, if you don't even want to have different DPIs, or if you need a few but not that many, you can choose here. And if you want the X and Y axis to behave independently, just check this box, enable X, Y axis, and you can adjust the slider, and they won't be tied to each other. You can adjust the lift-off distance right here, and then the polling rate on the right. For the lighting options, you can configure the hexagonal light-up area on the left, the mouse wheel, and the battle dragon independently, so you can turn whichever ones you want on or off. Link to program means when, say you have 5 different profiles on the mouse right now, and they all, if you link to a specific game for each of the 5, a different game, when you start loading that game, the software will automatically load the profile link to the game for you, so you don't have to even switch profiles. This is the macro manager. Over here you can create new macros, edit existing ones, or delete current ones. When you want to make a macro, you just hit record. Press whatever buttons you need. When you're done, hit stop. Right now we have delay time auto detecting checked right now. If it doesn't matter for the timing between how long it is before you each press a button, or how long you hold down a button for, and you just want the buttons to register, just check the ignore delay time and press buttons, and it'll ignore the timing. And then when you want to, say, edit a current macro you already have, but you've already recorded parts, you can just click wherever you need to edit and hit insert, and you can start recording in new parts into the macro like that. Well, this is the macro manager. Alright, that's the Ventus UI, everybody. Thanks for watching.